हेलो फ्रेंड, वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू दिस ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर SYBCOM CVCS पैटर्न 2019 एंड वेलकम टू दिस सेमेस्टर नंबर 4. द प्रीवियस सेमेस्टर नंबर 3 वी लर्न द मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स 4 चैप्टर एंड दिस सेमेस्टर वी आल्सो लर्न द 4 चैप्टर. सो लेट अस बिगिन विद द फर्स्ट चैप्टर व्हिच इज नेम इज मनी. बिफोर द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर वी नो द आवर पेपर पैटर्न and our code. The course code is 243 and course credit is 03 as per the similar to previous. So topic number 1 we learn in this semester about the money definition, function, demand for money, supply of money and the value of money and theories of value of money we learn in this semester. Then the second topic is about the inflation, causes of inflation, types of inflation and effects of inflation is the important in topic number 2. In the topic number 3, we discuss about the trade cycle, the phases of trade cycle, various definition of trade cycle, features of trade cycle, the measures to control of trade cycle and phases of trade cycle. The last topic is about the public finance, and about the public finance we know that the meaning of public finance, the importance of public finance, the nature scope of public finance, taxation, direct and indirect taxation, public debt and budget and types of budget in the last chapter. And first we begin with the our point, the topic 1, the money. And in this chapter we learn the so many points. The first is the meaning and the function of money, various definition given by the economics. Then the 1.2 is about the demand for money. There are the two approaches, classical approach for demand for money and Keynesian approach for demand for money. Then supply of money, the supply of money from the central bank. Then credit creation, function of the commercial bank and money measures of the RBI, M1, M2, M3, M4 and credit control methods of adopted by the central bank, quantitative tools and qualitative tools. And the last is the 1.4, the value of money. There are two approaches, the quantitative theory of money of Fisher and cash balance approach by the Marshall, Pigou and Robertson, means Cambridge approach. So let us begin with the money. And money is the important invention invented by the man, and it is important for the today's world. The beginning of the money, the world money is believed to originate from the temple of Hera and located in Capitolium, one of the Rome's seventh hills. The ancient world, the Hera was often associated with the money. The meaning of money. The money is any object or record that generally accept as the payment for money and goods, service and repayment of the debt in given the socio-economic context of the country. Money means what we use pay for the things a general call is the money. So every country use a different currency for their exchange and their transaction. Like the America use the dollar and India use the rupees and England use the pound. So every country has their different unit of the measurement of the money and different unit used for the their transaction and medium of exchange. So money is the anything object, any paper, any metal which is the general accepted as for the payment for goods and services and repayment and debt. It is possible to repayment of debt and socio-economic context. So any which is the use for the transaction. The money has defined on the basis of function of money. There is various function of money like the unit of account, store of value, occasionally in the past, standard of deferred payment. It is used tool for the repayment of the old loan and any kind of object, secured verifiable record, this function can be considered money. So any object, metal, paper, which is the accept generally everybody and which is used for the transaction, which is used for store for value, which is used for standard of deferred payment, it's called a money. So there is a different categories of the money, and today's world use the fiat money. It's also called the fake money. We for faith on the government, and that's why the government given the backing of one piece of the paper, and it's called the money. So Indian people call money for the rupees, and the American people call money for their dollar. And the second is the commodity money. In the ancient days, the different commodity used for the money, and bank money like the check and the bank document. The credit card is the creation of the bank money and virtual money. And now today days, the cryptocurrency is used for the virtual money. So one by one, we looking here the fiat money. What is mean by the fiat money or the fiat money? So whenever the government given the backing of the any piece of the paper, any metal, it's called the fiat money. And nearly contemporary money is a system are based on the fiat money. So today's all the economy use the fiat money. Like any check or note debt without the intrinsic value of physical commodity, it derives its the value by being the declared by the government is legal tender of money. So government declare the it is a legal tender of money, and government backing it's called the legal money. Like in India we use rupees and coin, which is have the government backing. So such law in the practice cause the fiat money accurate the value of money, goods and services that may be treated from with the nation that they issue it. So our money we looking here in the picture. Similarly, other country use their money. So when the government give the backing their money, and as per their law is called the fiat money or fiat money. The next is the commodity money. Just like the picture here, you seeing the some vegetables, fruits and the some food grains. The ancient days the some commodity money is like this. So money is the historical emergent market phenomena established commodity money. It's mean the something whose value serve the value of money. So in the ancient days the some cow, sheep means the cattle wealth, the wheat, rice, tobacco and tiger teeth, elephant tusk, the anything the which is used for the medium of exchange is called the commodity money. So and there are some problem into the commodity money like the like durability, absence of standard of forms, different region use the different commodity. So now these days all contemporary money system are based on the fiat money, and but ancient days the people use the food grain and vegetables and many other things as a commodity money. So second type is the commodity money. The third one is the bank money. Here we looking one check and the credit card. So as per the picture you see here, the bank money means the what is the creation of bank, the check or the credit card and debit card. The money supply of the country is consist of currency, means like a bank note and coin and bank money. The balance held the checking of account and saving account. So bank money consists only the record, the mostly computers record in the modern banking the transaction from one account to another account. So computers record it's called the bank money. Forms of the far largest part of money supply is the developed nation. As you know it, the present money consists of coin, currency note and deposit money, consist of check, demand draft, credit card, debit card, etc. is the bank money. The present day money has also a pass through three stages. So bank money is also we can use in our daily life. The modern day the money is passing these three stages. First we use the metallic money, after that the metal is the scarce, that's why we use the paper money for the our transaction. Then the representative paper money is emerged, after that the metallic money, and now there is some we use the credit money, the credit card and debit card for our transaction. So another one important types emerge in today's world, like this picture, it is the Bitcoin. It is the virtual money, the it's called also cryptocurrency. The virtual currency can be defined as an electronic representation of monetary value that may be issued, managed and controlled private user, developer and funding of organization. So this private issuer and developer is generate this kind of virtual money, and it is the only corporate transaction. Such virtual currency are often represent in the term of token and may be remain the unregulated without a legal tender money. It is many country, it's not a legal tender form of the money. Unlike the regular money of virtual currency rely on the system of trust. It is based on only the trust of the people, may not be issued by the central bank or the other banking regulatory authority. In India, our central bank or Reserve Bank of India are not given the authorization of this virtual money and cryptocurrency. They derive the value based on the underlying the mechanism, like the mining in case of the cryptocurrency or other banking, by the underlying the asset. So anyone who was the cryptocurrency price in online will saw the effect of the psychological of trading, and he can transact with the Bitcoin, he can purchase the Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, the Ethereum are considered to be part of the virtual currency of group. The cryptocurrency means the virtual only transaction of the money. There is no any representative of the money, not a metal, not a paper. There is only virtual transaction, online transaction. That's why it's called the virtual money. So cryptocurrency use the cryptography technology that keep the transaction secure and authentic, and also help to manage the control of creation of new currency of unit. Such cryptocurrency exists and transacts over the dedicated blockchain based network that are open to the common public. Anyone can join and start the transaction with this cryptocurrency. So these are things we looking at the categories of money: commodity money, then we looking the fiat money, then we looking the bank money and virtual money. Here we looking the some definition as per our syllabus, as per our book. The definition are the important for our examination. So looking here, we first definition of Walker definition. According to the economist Walker, money is what money does. So money does the medium of exchange, money does the store of value, money is the standard of the deferred payment. So money means what money does. It is the medium of exchange done, it is the done by the store of value. So money means what money does, what money function. The next definition is given by the Seligman. Money means a thing possess a general acceptability. So anything which is the general acceptability called the money. So Indian people call the money for the piece of paper, which is the rupees, which is given the government backing, and the American people call money for their dollar because of the general acceptability of that region, that part and that country. So the next definition is given another economist, the Crowther. Money can anything that generally acceptable as a medium of exchange, and that at the same time act the measure and the store of value. So the Crowther's definition is the more broad definition. Consider the Seligman part of the definition and Walker part of the definition. So money means anything which is generally acceptable in the country, which is used for medium of exchange, that same time act measure the value of goods and services and store of value. So in Indian rupees we can accept from the Kanyakumari to the Kashmir, the which is the money 500 notes or 2000 notes. It is used for medium of change. It is same time act measure. We measure the goods and services value, and we can also store these money. So money which is generally acceptable and medium of exchange, and at same time measure and the store of value means the money. So Crowther definition is the more appropriate definition. The next definition is given by the Professor Pigou. According to Professor A.C. Pigou, in order of anything to be classed as money, it must be accepted fairly widely as an instrument of exchange. So any instrument it is widely accept for the exchange, it's called the money according to Pigou. Robertson definition. According to D.H. Robertson, money anything which widely accept in the payment for the goods or the discharge for the other kind of business obligation. So which is the widely acceptable for the payment of goods and discharge any kind of business obligation means the money according to Robertson. The next definition of D.H. Cole, the money is anything that the habitually and widely used means of the payment and generally acceptable in the settlement of debt. So it's a money. So anything which is the widely acceptable, which is the use for the payment and which is the use for settlement of the debt, it's called the money according to various economics. So money means what money does. Money does the medium of exchange. Money does the store of value. Money does the measures of the goods and services price. So anything which is the function of money is called the money. So different country call a different unit as a money. So in India we call the rupee is the money, and American people call dollar is their money. So some of the qualities of the good money we discussed here, that every country's money has some qualities. So every time we looking into the what is the quality of good money, so there is a certain things are necessary. Generally acceptability, whether it is a dollar or whether it is the rupees, general acceptability in that country, that region, all the people accept it is the money. So general acceptability is necessary, and when the government give the backing and law is given backing, that time there is the general acceptability considered in that good money. The next is the diversity. There is a possible to divert the money in the shorter form, like the money is divided in the main form, 10 rupees note, 20 rupees note, 500 notes, 100 rupees note and 2000 rupees note. So diversity into the note and coin, it is the necessary quality for the good money. The next thing is about the durability. So the current time the durability is important, and commodity money is the lacking the this feature of durability, but the metallic money and paper money or plastic money is more durable comparatively to the other type of money like the commodity money. So durability is a necessary thing for good quality of money. The next thing is the identifiable. So any common man that identify from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, it's a 100 rupees notes or the 10 rupees note or the 500 rupees notes. So identifiable, simply it is the identify the any person. So it is the good quality of the money. The next important quality of the money is the portability. So there is the portability is necessary. The port is possible to one from one area to another area. There is the portability is important from transfer the money from one region to another region or one country to another country. So portability is the important feature. The next is the homogeneity. So all notes are the similar. The 10 rupees all notes are the similar size and form, similar color. The 100 rupees notes is also similar size. So old note and the new notes are all are the same size. So homogeneity, so there is the simplicity and homogeneity is important to identify the money within the second. The next stability of value. Money has the more stable value. The rupee has a more stable as compared to the commodity, because the commodity is the value change as per the time and the situation. So commodity is not a stable value, but money and rupees and dollar have the more stable value. So any good money have the quality of stable value. The last thing, the liquidity. We can transfer the asset into the money form, and money is also transferred into the liquid form. So liquidity is the important characteristics of the money. So any money is important to convert the asset into the liquid form. So these are the quality of the good money. So here we looking at some summary what we learn from this lecture. The money means what we use to pay for the things are generally called money. So different country have a different piece of paper called money. Money is any object, metal or the paper, record that generally accept payment for the goods and services and repayment of debt in a given socio-economic context of the country. So it is used for the payment of goods services and debt is given to socio-economic context. The money has a defined on the basis of their functions. There is a different functions like the you need to account store of value occasionally in the past payment, the standard of deferred payment, any kind of object secure, the verifiably record, this function can be considered as a money. And we also discussed the some category of fiat money or fake money when the government gives the backing, government made money as per their law, it's called the fake money. And representative paper money used by the today's all economy, commodity money, the ancient days used the commodity money. Then bank money we use in our transaction, and today's world we are so looking some cryptocurrency is a virtual money. The definition of money, so money means what money does, given the definition of the Crowther, it is the shortest definition of the money. Money can be anything that is generally acceptable of medium of exchange and that same time act measure and store of value, it's called money. So different country have the different currency of money, and good quality of money, the money should be durable, it is the portable, homogeneity and durability, the certain things is required for the quality of good money. So you can use some references for this point, the ML Jingan macroeconomic theory, H. L. Ahuja macroeconomic theory, Russell R. G. S. P. Adaw, Kapdi Guttiger business economics macro, Prashant publication books also available for your study. So these are the books. Assignment question on this point, what is the question will be asked in the examination for 5 marks, meaning and definition of money, what are the qualities of money and categories of or the types of money like fiat money, commodity money, then the virtual money or bank money. So these are the assignment question will be asked in examination. So thank you for watching this video. The next time we will be looking the next point in next video. Thank you.